Hi friends, today the recipe which I'm going to show you, for that these ingredients we need. This is a very limited ingredients. You can prepare this recipe for your lunch or tiffin box. So here we have butter. This butter I'll use 2 to 3 times. And here we have paneer, and this is tomato puree, sesame seeds and cashew paste, this one, and almost 1/2 inch of ginger, chopped coriander, boiled potato, green capsicum, and garam masala powder, 2 green chilies. Green chilies you can make it more or less as per your taste. This is homemade fresh cream which I am storing for a few days. Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today's recipe is going to be very easy. Hope you like this video. So come, let's see the process. Homemade paneer I am going to use here today. This is almost 1.5 liter milk I have used for this. The weight almost 200 grams or 180 grams. This homemade paneer recipe is there in my channel. I'll give you the link in the description box below so you can check out. So here I'll cut the paneer into few pieces. For this recipe I have added only capsicum. If you don't want to add only capsicum, you can go with only paneer. And if you want more vegetables, so you can add carrot, beans, capsicum, any vegetable which you like. For this paneer recipe, I am using only butter. Approx 50 grams of butter I have taken, but at a time I am not using. I will be using later half. I am using now half. Here I will be adding green chili, capsicum, and boiled potatoes also I'm going to add now. So we'll just little bit saute this for a few minutes. After that I'll go with the next process. Now I'm going to add the chopped ginger. If you don't want to add chopped ginger, you can add ginger paste also, but personally I like to add chopped ginger only, so I'm not using paste here. If you want to add ginger paste, that you can add it. Here I have taken 2 medium size of tomato. I have put it in the mixer grinder and I make a paste of that. Fresh tomato puree I'm adding here. We'll just saute for a few minutes and we'll cover the lid and wait for some time. After adding the tomato puree, now I am going to add the salt. Salt will help the tomato to cook well. We'll wait for some time. We'll cover the lid again. After a few minutes, now I am going to open the lid and I am going to add all spices here. Red chili powder and Kashmiri lal mirch powder I am adding now. Now we will cook for some time all the masalas, tomato and vegetables. Little bit of hot water I am adding here. It will help all the things together to cook well. We will wait for some time and we will cover the lid again. And 1 to 2 minutes again we will cook this. And then we'll open the lid and we'll go with the next process. I'm going to cover the lid now for a few minutes. Now I will add the paste which I have made. Sesame seed, poppy seeds and cashew paste. I have taken 10 pieces of cashews. You can reduce the cashews as per your choice. And sesame seed I have taken 1 tablespoon and poppy seeds 2 tablespoons. So why I have added sesame seed? If you don't have the poppy seed, you can go with only sesame seeds, and if you don't have sesame seed, you can go with poppy seeds also. So here I am adding paneer cubes. This time we can add the sugar and salt. I have added sugar, so we can see the salt. If needed we can add. I am adding the butter, remaining butter and the remaining paste now. Uh, Now I will add one green chili. I'll just break it into two pieces and we can cover the lid. We'll keep it for some time. After 2 minutes, I'm adding the hot water where I have made the paste. Now I'm just checking the salt is little less, so I have added the salt. Here our dish is ready. We'll give it a good mix here and I'm going to add some fresh creams. 2 tablespoons of fresh creams I'm adding now. We'll just add the garam masala and the fresh creams as well, and we'll give a good mix. I'm not so garam masala fan, so I'm not adding more. If you want, you can go with more garam masala powder, and you must add kasuri methi. But sorry, I don't have kasuri methi today, so I'm adding fresh coriander leaves. You just add kasuri methi here if you have. That will give you a very nice flavor in this recipe. Yeah, our dish is ready. I'm going to serve this with drumstick paratha, drumstick leaves paratha actually. This recipe is going to come on my channel very soon. So hope you like this video, guys. If you like my video, please don't forget to subscribe my channel and give me a thumbs up so I'll get little more motivation for next video. Thank you for watching. Bye.